Hey, you guys, thought I'd give you a video today that's actually somewhat helpful. Those of you who know me will know that I have occasionally played Automation on stream, and this is a game where you get to design and build your own cars. Recently, they added an update where you can actually take these cars and export them into the popular physics toy box game thing called BeamNG. And this is pretty exciting because for the first time ever, you can kind of just build your own car and test it all within a video game. However, building cars is complicated because there's a lot of, like, stuff. Thankfully, you've got me here to show you how to do that. First thing you're going to want to determine is the time period, and that may seem tedious, but it's actually very important. This will determine whether your car is a soulless plastic bubble, a slightly older soulless plastic bubble, a Grand Theft Auto San Andreas reject, or an epitaph to the excesses of American culture. Being slightly impartial to shitboxes myself, I think we're going to go back to the 80s with this one. We're just gonna make a sedan because, I don't know, I'm not creative. Now, here's where you get your first set of choices. This is where you can choose if you want to make your suspension and chassis out of really advanced shit, like aluminum with wishbone suspension, or you can just good enough. Alright, next part's the engine. Because we want this car to kick ass, we're gonna give it a V8. Because we want that V8 not to suck, we're gonna make it American. Because we're gonna make it American, we're gonna make it out of Stone Age materials. Here's the most important part, where you pick the bore and stroke of your engine. This basically determines how big it is. Gonna fucking take those and yeah, that's good. Alright, now for some more technical stuff. I'm just kidding, I'm gonna pick all the cheapest shit. Compression, whatever. Cam profile, normal. I'm not a fucking communist, so we're not gonna have any turbos. Now here's where we get a really interesting choice. In the 80s, people made the switch over from carburetors, which were like old, to injectors, which were new. But I don't give a shit. I'm gonna make it run on regular ass fuel. Lots of regular ass fuel. And then exhausts. I don't think we need a catalytic converter. Yeah, I'm sure that's all good. Oh. Okay, I fixed everything. Turns out the engine just doesn't want to rev past 4,300 RPM. Which, if you don't know anything about engines, 4,300 RPMs is, it's a pretty good one to shoot for. And then we just give that bad boy a good name. So now we're gonna just basically do everything else. Just make it a regular ass, gigantic sedan. Here you can like morph the body into shit. I'm gonna just make it, that looks good, I guess. So now we're at the paint, and because of that recent debacle I had with Twitch, I probably lost some points with the fat homosexuals. So we're just gonna go ahead and yeah, that looks good. Now I'm gonna add the fixtures, which are like lights and shit. This is really boring, so I'm just gonna skip this. Alright, so let me run you through what I've done. In the front, we've got our standard grill arrangement here, so that we get plenty of air. Also, I put rally lights on here, so I can live out my fantasy of being Ken Block, because I'm a worthless piece of shit. On the sides, I added some, like, stuff that nobody gives a shit about. And then when I got to the back, I kind of just stopped caring, so, you know, chrome.
Everything is chrome in the future!
Always make your car rear-wheel drive, because that's the best. You really don't need more than two gears. Yeah, I'm sure it'll reach that eventually. Tires just, like, kind of do whatever. So do this, that, this, do this. Yeah, some of these. Air suspension. If you don't like a 353 horsepower, two-speed beast, then there's something fucking wrong with you. Now, I think it's time to give this a name. Let's do what we came here for and just export this shit to BeamNG. The first thing I'm gonna do is just take this for a whiz around test track. I prefer to use Hirochi Short because the automation test track. Well, it's just too fucking long. Anyway, that car you just saw driving, I ran a 128.7 around this track with an economy 90 horsepower engine. This has almost 4 times as much horsepower, so it should be a lot faster. Okay. Alright, right off the bat, we have some gear ratio issues, some slight handling issues, just a little bit. This thing is not a huge fan of turning in a controlled manner. Full disclosure, I don't have a wheel, but you know, this isn't good. I'm completely incapable of accelerating because my second gear is supposed to cover everywhere from 55 to like 120. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so you know how I said that economy car with a 90 horsepower engine ran a 128.7? In lieu of that, I suppose my time is less than ideal. We'll just market it as a luxury car. So if we're gonna market this as a luxury car, we better see how well it does over some bumps. I mean, I've seen a lot worse, I guess. Fuck. Okay, so here in, like, the outside area, you get just a bunch of flat land. It's pretty good for testing fuel economy and highway performance. Now, I know this thing has a giant engine, but it should get relatively decent highway fuel economy. In theory. Well, you know what? This is just a game, so I'm willing to bet that that MPG rating is a bit skewed and probably not accurate. So, like, this thing will probably get really bad fuel economy, too. In theory. Okay, well, so far, our car has yielded mixed results, but I realized something. This is a big four-door American V8 sedan thing. The only important test is how well it goes around banked left turns. Well, how about that, Jeff Gordon? Eat your heart out. I suppose after that bombshell, the only conclusion we can make is that the Autism GT here is a resounding success. And I think with this advice, you guys should be good to make cars of your own. If you liked this video, or for some fucking reason, like, subscribe or something, check out my Discord, my Patreon. If there's one thing I enjoy in life, it is your money and spending it on things. Otherwise, check out my stupid videos about, like, stuff. I'll put them on the screen here.